Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning into Badass Travels. My name is Ashley and today I'm going to share with you five things that I think you should know before traveling in a pandemic. As of right now, traveling is highly discouraged in order to stop the spread of COVID-19, but it's still available to you. The travel industry did take a huge hit, and the way things are different is that a lot of the flight crew were furloughed or laid off, and a lot of their routes and destinations have been cut significantly. If it is absolutely necessary for you to travel, or if you have the vaccine, which I think is going to be a necessity in order to travel in the future, then I do have some tips for you and you should know. Number one, do your research. If you clicked on this video, you're already one step ahead of the game. Really important for you to be prepared because things are changing all the time. There were some countries in 2020 that we were allowed to go to. Right now in 2021, we're not allowed to go there. Make sure you go on the official website of the country or the city that you're going to. Double check to see if you're going to need to take a COVID test 72 hours prior, a negative test, or if we're even allowed. Number two, wear your masks. When you purchase a ticket, you are accepting, you understand that it is a requirement to put your masks on at all times in flight unless you're eating or drinking. Also, a little tip, the masks with the vents on it, those aren't allowed on some major airlines because the airflow that still keeps going in and out, it's not as protective. Number three, bring your own food and an empty water bottle or, like me, a hydro flask. A lot of airlines have cut beverage and food services in order to keep things safe. They do have a meal on international flights, but some tip that some people do not know, it is okay to bring food through TSA as long as it's not like super, it's soup or liquidy. The food is all right. Sandwiches are cool snacks. I always bring snacks wherever I go, and then there's always the availability to purchase food at the terminal as well. And then for empty water bottles, there are always a source of getting water at the airport too. If you want to go to like a cafe, like in the terminal, or there are a lot of filtered water stations as well. And just another little tip for you, if you are going to be bringing food internationally, like fruits, make sure you finish your fruits before you land. Most countries don't allow you to bring in fresh produce into other countries, and Hawaii included. Number four, keep it clean. I personally believe that when we fly, we should be observing gym rules. Wipe it down before you use it, wipe it after you use it. Tray table, seat belts, the window shade that you use. Like, I think that you should always wipe it down, even before COVID. That's what I always do. I always recommend bring your own hand sanitizers. Baby wipes, wax on, wax off. Do it all, my friend. Yes, we have cleaners on the plane, but these planes also do go in and out real fast, and sometimes there's a time limit. You know, there are some stubborn little germs out there that might pass through. So that's my little two cents. And if you're gonna take your shoes off in flight, which I totally understand, little side tip for that. If you are gonna be taking your shoes off in flight, which trust me, I totally understand, don't take your shoes off until after takeoff. In the case there is an emergency and you do have to evacuate, you don't wanna be lacing up your shoes when you should be out of there if something does happen. And that's, you know, not to sound scary or morbid, but as a flight attendant, that's our job. It's our job to think about all these things that may happen. Number two side tip is don't wear just your socks or your bare feet in the lavatories as well. There is turbulence when people are going to the restroom, and you know, it's just a little thing to think about, you know, no judgment. Tip number five, do not expect your flight to be empty. There are a lot of flights that are empty, but there are a lot of flights that are even more full depending on the destination that you're going to, because a lot of the routes, a lot of the destinations have been minimized. So that means more full flights, and there might be people around you. So if you are a little bit anxious about traveling or all those things, then just keep that in mind if there's another alternative for you. And just because I like you, I'm gonna give you a little bonus tip. Bring a portable charger. Mine is the RAV Power. I've had it with me for 7 years, and this thing has gone with me to every city, every country, every beach destination, every jungle. It's taken me everywhere. I got the USB with the little flashlight. I'll link that for you. Some planes have plugs for chargers, some planes don't. Some planes have entertainment systems, some don't. But as of right now, I think a lot of airlines are transitioning to through the Wi-Fi, allowing passengers to watch free entertainment on their personal devices. And so this thing helps a lot. And my last bonus tip for you, my future traveler, like for real, this will be my last tip. Be nice to your flight attendant, always. Be nice to your flight crew, be nice to the agents. In this super, super weird time right now, they are exposing themselves in order to help you get from destination A to destination B safe and sound. Honestly, for everybody, these times are different. And we had a whole year to see that. Travel is coming back. It's gonna take some time. People are still traveling. And if you do, I just want you to be prepared. If you have any more travel questions, don't be afraid to comment below or to message me. Go on my Instagram, on my website, email me, anything. I'm here for you. This is what this page is all about. It might help ease those questions for traveling. If you like this, don't forget to subscribe. And thank you so much. Peace.